Hello everybody, Eamon and Storm here, and welcome back to Hearts of Iron 4, the Kingdom of Greece. In the last episode, we started things in a bit of a pickle. The Soviet Union had declared war on the German Reich, and Germany in response moved their entire military to the Soviet front, leaving a gaping hole for the French and the British on the Western Front. We responded by moving our forces into the region to try to stem the advance of the Allies. And not only were we able to do that, we actually forced the event to occur where Germany occupied northern France and established Vichy France. I'm not sure if that's from the new version or not. It might be. And now we are pushing along the northern coast of Europe here with one of my armies in an attempt to sweep through, deny them the coast, create a pocket here, and then destroy whatever forces we can. We have a pocket here, which has a lot of enemy divisions in it. I mean, not as many as I'd like, but, you know, a significant amount. Vichy France has a bunch of enemy forces in it, which we're going to have to swing in and deal with in a moment, but it looks like the Allied forces on mainland Europe have a limited amount of time left before they are destroyed. So, that's a good thing. We need to first get through here. I need to send a unit over to Cherbourg to take that port to prevent any more enemy forces from landing. We also have some enemy forces over here we need to deal with. So, we're not entirely secure yet, but we're in a much better position at the start of this episode than we were at the start of last episode. So, it looks like we're probably going to be able to survive. Maybe. Okay, the other thing is, I wanted to do real quick is take these guys and merge all those ships into the main fleet. Then we'll distribute things back out from there. And we're also having some issues with enemy planes. It looks like they withdrew their bombers, so that is good. Alright, let's just go ahead and unpause it. Let's get things moving. Let's keep it fairly slow for the time being as we get things in position. Now, I think these are enemy subs. Oh, yeah, France capitulated. Yeah, we're aware of that. So actually, what I want to do is I want to separate off the submarines into their own fleet, give them an admiral, and I want to move this fleet into port somewhere for now. What I want to do is also, I want to separate off the destroyers, give them a new admiral, select them, and tell them, do we have like, very wide. Yeah, let's put them on patrol. And this is the main fleet. What I'm going to do is I'm going to order them back to port for the time being. And what I need to do is submarines are now going to go into... hold on. Let's rename this. Let's call this, Subforce 1, just so that we know what that is. And here, this is going to be... Subhunters. For now. Okay, so we want our submarines to go into Subforce 1. We want our destroyers to go into the subhunters for now. So I think these are Romanian submarines that are still kicking around and will be until we finally defeat the Allies completely. Are they leaving? I think they left. Good. Everybody, destroy those guys. Actually, you two? I want to give you guys a front down here. Two divisions. Let's actually give those guys on that front down there. And then what we'll say is, attack. Where those guys think they're retreating. Can you guys, like, get over there? Yeah, get over there. Not exactly sure how many divisions that is, but we'll find out in a moment. Alright, what actually I'm going to do is I'm going to take these tanks, I'm going to drive them around and attack those guys from that angle. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take these guys, I'm going to shorten up. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my tanks and I'm going to tell them to push that way. Now that is a lot of enemy divisions right there. We definitely want to catch them. And you guys, I give you orders to push like this. Improved computing machine. Very nice. Is it 42 yet? No, it is not 42. Let's go ahead and get radio detection. Just kind of knock that out. Oh, there's only one division there. Okay, no big deal. Can all of you guys just pour in? Just pour in. Wipe those, 9 divisions out. Okay. It looks like the Germans are collapsing this pocket. That's good. There's not much left in there after the French got defeated. And pretty much all their army is gone now. Looks like my tanks ran into trouble. Tell them to join in. Oh, that is a bunch of guys in Amsterdam. Can I take a division and move them into Eindhoven? Let's just tell them to push this way. Okay, we wipe those guys out. So let's move these guys to this front here. Get this Allied force contained. Destroyed. And our allies are coming here, so we're gonna get some help here pretty soon. Infantry focus. Very nice. Island infrastructure, don't need to worry about that. Let's go with computing focus, so we get a bonus on that computing technology, so we can just research it real fast. Okay. Still waiting to join the war against the Soviets. Alright, so then you guys, we're gonna say... push... like that. Engage as soon as you're ready. Everybody on that front. We've isolated 11, 13, 16 divisions here. But they do have supplies from this naval base, so... without some help, they're going to be hard to defeat with just my eight divisions? I thought there were 9 divisions in an army. Just make sure there isn't any problems going on. No, we're good. Well, looks like we created a pocket. Right, you guys just collapse in there. Just start attacking them. You guys, halt. Tell you guys to stop. They need to recover. And in fact, what I want to do is I want to give them a battle plan. So they can start building some bonus. I hope the Germans haven't compromised the Soviet front too much. I definitely need to get involved into this war soon, so that I get participation credit. I'm gonna wait till we get good planning bonus before we move on that. Where are we getting resistance? Resistance out here. We've got resistance out there, but we don't have any troops out there. I don't know why this garrisoning AI is not spreading these guys out better than they are. Stacking 3 divisions up on Beirut is not that necessary. We were able to eliminate the resistance here. All right, let's just go. Signal company, okay. We want to improve... let's improve my engineer companies. And what I want to do is go in here and edit, add in signal companies to everybody that has an available slot for it. I guess, no, those guys don't, so that should be fine. Alright, go ahead and get everybody on that front. Looks like they're evacuating. Okay, so let's attack it. Why don't these guys have any organization? That's my question. Not suffering any attrition, so there's nothing I really need to worry about. But the Germans are here, so... Well, it looks like we're gonna take Amsterdam. Alright, so you guys can actually delete that order right there. Get everybody on this front. I need to get them cut off. Cut them off. They don't actually have any ports. Well, those guys do, but these guys do not. So they are... These guys are done. Take Brussels. Well, looks like we're gonna get that. Amsterdam is ours. The Hague is next. Well, we're taking Rotterdam. Wait, we actually might be making some headway here. Yep, Brussels is now ours once more. These guys are almost destroyed. Everybody pour into Marseille. And they either evacuated or were wiped out. I can't tell which. Alright, so that is nice and clean. Nice and clean. Oh, looks like the British decided to land some troops. Alright, so those guys are knocked out. Problem is that the Brits are probably going to do constant naval invasions. So can you guys just attack them? Let's see, they are arrayed along this border here, but not here. Let's bring my main troops back down here and give them that front. I'm going to bring this army back down here. And array them there. This army is going to remain a quick response force in Europe. Mainly to protect the French coast. They brought 11 divisions there. Unless you do it this way. Let them spread out. Or not. And my planes that I had up here. Let's bring them back down there. These guys come over here. Let's get everybody together, merge them up, and then we'll figure out what to do with them. Can I bring, like, and maybe, like, some of my tanks over here? And then tell them to attack here so we get them from multiple angles, so we get the bonus for that. Oh, they keep landing more and more and more troops in here. I hope the Italians are sending troops to the Soviet border. Italy's basically conquered all of Africa. Nice job, Italy. Oop, dive bombing. Nice. Get direct ground support. Oh, we have some more military factories. What do we want to put them on? I think we probably want to go with infantry equipment. Continue to build that up. Alright, so they're down in one division, so either they're evacuating or they're dying. Construction 3. Okay. So what I'm going to actually do is I'm going to take you guys and give you a fallback line from Brest through Le Havre to Dunkirk. Spread them out along the French coast. Let's go with that. Increase the efficiency of our factories. That's always a good thing. Oh, we're at zero manpower. I didn't even realize that. Let's see. Factory output minus 10%, construction speed minus 10%, training time. Well, let's switch to service by requirement. So you get us some more troops. More people to utilize. Army is suffering attrition. Local infrastructure, 25% of previous infrastructure. Okay, well, I'm gonna need to take them and split them up. Delete this. Take these guys and put them on there. That 20 divisions. Actually, let's just do this. Unassign all the currently selected divisions. Make them into a new army. Make them a general. different color. And then deploy them down here for the time being. And then what we want to do is we want to improve the infrastructure. Through here. And make that a priority. We do need the military factories, but... Alright, close air supports, merge them up. Fighters, merge them up. Alright, what do we got on our hands? We have 200 naval bombers. There's only 800 aircraft that can fit there, so we're gonna have to reduce these. Yeah, we're gonna have to reduce these to probably 300 apiece. Looks like the Germans are pushing past our border. Okay. Right now, these guys don't have any resistance. So are we ready to join the war? Is anybody suffering attrition right now that I need to worry about? Belongs to an army but has no orders assigned. Oh, now they do. Okay. Because right now, I just do not have the fleet or the air force to challenge the British directly on their territory. I mean, my fleet would probably get sunk on the way there before I could even get it in the field. We do need to take care of this stuff down here in a bit. The French and the British are pushing to get back against the Italians. We are going to need to help with this though. One thing I probably want to do is take this off a priority, start getting some material into these new divisions that we are training. See, we're 195 days away from being able to... Oh, confusing focus. Alright. Motorization. Motorized. Army experience plus 100. Land doctrine. Alright. Let's start working on the Navy focuses. How long till we get our first carrier? In 8.4 months. And we are starting to build some carrier fighters and carrier naval bombers. Ooh, I need to set the default loadout. Oh, that should be fine. Okay. Oh, looks like the Soviets are moving forces into position to respond to my positioning. But I'm like really far behind on equipment here. Don't have anybody undergoing attrition. Nobody's in combat. I don't understand why I would be losing gear. Production deficit of -5 units of anti-air per day. Where are we using up anti-air? We're not getting bombed anywhere. We have fighter cover over northern France. What are we short on resources? We need some rubber and some steel. Alright, so go for steel. Sweden. Give us some more steel. Rubber. I guess we'll go ahead and get some rubber from Japan. Still need some more rubber. Apparently Japan is not doing anything. Well, probably have to build our own synthetic plants for the rubber. We could probably just piecemeal it. That's a very inefficient use of our factories, though. Oh, wait, hold on. German Reich just opened up trade. Did they? There we go. That's a better use of our factories. Alright, well, we're probably going to go ahead. We're going to end this episode here. We've been able to secure Europe. Except for Gibraltar, which we might have to do something about that eventually. And we are probably just about ready. Nope, they're deploying their forces. I had my chance to declare it without being contested, but I took too long. Alright, well, we don't really have any threat on this border anymore, so it might be time to go ahead and do it. And now we're actually positive across the board. And I would really like to get... there's no way we're gonna be good on light tanks. Alright, we'll have to look at this and make some decisions for next episode. So, hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Go ahead, like, subscribe, and comment, and I will see you next time.